Hi, I'm Sean Kinney.
I'm Michael Reed McLaughlin.
We're the judges for the 2012 Social Media Film Festival.
We're going to talk about our experience at the festival, which was outstanding. You know, I was really surprised and pleasantly surprised at how many fantastic films we had submitted. And such a wide range from shorts, documentaries, narratives. Really outstanding films submitted to this festival. It made our job really hard, unfortunately, didn't it?
It did make it hard. You pray for good films, but once you get good films, you're like, oh, now I have to eliminate one. Yeah. And then reality sets in. But it's better to have a great batch of films than a lot of bad films. And we had exceptional films. It was great to judge a film festival through the context of social media, looking at how is social media active within the film, how did the films participate in social media, because some continue to participate outside or even after the film. And so it was really interesting to see the context of how social media was coming into film at this point and where it's leading into film after this.
Yeah, it's a really interesting time right now, not just with social media that we see already, that the people are rising up. In the documentaries we saw about how advertising has completely been turned on its head and marketing completely turned on their head by this idea that people, through social interaction, through the tweet, through Twitter, through Facebook, through their reviews, are putting pressures on the industry to perform, to deliver a product that meets what people want instead of what they're told they want. And so that we know about already. We also know that you can buy a camera. Any kid, you know, in Iowa can buy a camera and shoot a good-looking film. Mm-hmm. For nothing. And now they're sort of coming together where the people through social media, I think we're going to see getting more and more involved in filmmaking in social ways. We haven't really seen that yet, but I think that's coming where, I don't know, there's going to be an app where people are adding what's the next element, or they're adding, some people are shooting different scenes or characters come and go through that virtual space or something. I don't know what it is, but I'm excited to see what it's going to
be. I agree. I think the current state of where you have something like a Funny or Die or a YouTube or Vimeo, where people are starting to exchange films and film projects, small shorts, you know, the micro films, the 5-second ones, now people are throwing them from cell phone to cell phone with such frequency. If something goes viral, everyone has it at every level on every type of different medium of device. And I think the future is only going to keep expanding in those areas. So social media, not only is it going to be a film in a theater, but it's going to be all the ancillary products of that film that you can share.
Right.
My kids already have screensavers from their favorite movies,
Well, where you're in the film, participating on, you know, how is it going to end? You know, I don't like this character, let's kill this character. Or I really like this character, where has she been? And is, you know, maybe people are going to be tweeting about that. That's going to affect what they're seeing on the screen or whatever. We don't know yet, but it's an exciting time.
Very exciting time. It's an exciting time to be part of the festival that's starting the marriage of those two things, an examination of the marriage of film and social media. So very exciting time. It was an exciting first year, and it's the hype has already started for next year, and that's what we can't wait for.
Yeah, we're really excited about that. I think we've heard some interesting ideas. You know, where is this festival going to be next year? Maybe not Las Vegas. Maybe it's going to be different places all the time. Because of the fact that it is a social media, social change film festival, means it's going to be different. And that might be that it takes place in virtual spaces. Or it might be that it travels. It's here this year, it's there that year, but it's always a social. It's not stuck in Park City. It's not stuck in Toronto. It's not stuck anywhere. It maybe that's what we're going to see. Or we don't know. But it's going to be interesting, exciting, I think.
It definitely. And I learned another thing at the festival. In order to be a judge, you have to wear a hat and have a gray beard.
Apparently. Yeah. Well, maybe we shouldn't have given that criteria.
No,
guys, that's what
everyone will be judging that. Yeah.